Hello my dear friends, welcome to my new video, and today we're gonna talk about serger or overlock machine. And I will go over three main things that you need to remember while start stitching and actually stitching in using your overlock, and also two main things that you need to use if you need to adjust the quality stitching to the perfect quality of stitching. So the first things to remember that the needle size need to be 80 or 90, or it will be 11 or 14, depends on the system you use. The threads, you can use this industrial size bobbins, they work perfect for overlock, but if you want to use domestic size of bobbins like this type, you need to buy exactly threads for overlock. This will be the perfect choice. Also, if you decided to use special and threads for a knit fabric, you know, like that special thread that will be also stretchy and will contains of different threads inside and like structurized thread, then you will need to use them only for two loopers thread. For needle threads, you do not need to use. You will use for needle threads, use the regular threads. Second thing to remember, it's a proper threading of your overlock. It's very important for proper stitching that you follow your manual, or for example, in my overlock, you see that I have this small like sticker over here, and it shows the numbers like one. It's an order which I need to follow when I am threading my overlock. So first of all, I need to thread my upper looper. The second, as you can see here, the second will be lower looper. The third, I need to thread the right needle, and the fourth, the last one, it will be the left needle. For example, you can even switch it. It doesn't matter big difference. You just need to be sure to make sure that when you pull them through this part, that they are not twisted and you do not confuse them between each other. So how to check it? You can easily, like for example, pull one of them, and if you're pulling like right, you need to see that over here the right thread, you see, will be pulling down. So that means that you're in the right in the right order, you threaded them in the right order. But if you're talking about loopers, what they do, so the mechanism of forming the chain stitch in this machine, the needles goes like in the center, and the upper looper usually, and the upper looper will go in the front of the needle over here. You can see it, you see it goes in front of a needle. And lower looper, you cannot see it from here, but if it's hiding, you can see that needles goes in front of them. So looper actually goes like behind needles. So basically, like needles, one looper goes in front and another looper goes behind. This is how they form this beautiful you see, beautiful lay of threads. So upper looper forming it in a top, and the lower looper forming it in the bottom. I purposely put these different colors of threads so we can see clearly which looper put which thread in the which side. Okay, so it will be very important. Then you thread the upper lever first, the looper first, and this one the second. So then when they go around the needle, they will not twist between each other. And then each stitch will be forming properly. And the third thing to remember, if your thread is got broken somewhere, like you for example was stitching and your thread has got broken, let's say over here, And then you see, like for example now, my needles are down over here, like inside of the, like for example, if it could be inside of the fabric or just now down, and the one looper is up. So it is the proper way how you can fix it and how you can thread the looper. You need to start from the default position. You need to rise the needle into the upper position. You need to pull, you see, the threads from the, you see, from the chain stitch, you see. So then you have all the threads separate, you see. Now, can even pull a little bit more, okay, separate them. Then you can have your blue thread. Let's say your red thread is gone, yeah, so you have just three threads. So you brought it in a position like you would be threading it now from the zero, from the like a new overlock. And then you need to go through all the steps and thread it again. So I will do it now. Okay, so we basically put it through first, second, and third, you see that? So yeah, this looper is already threaded, as we didn't touch it, but this, I will put it through the hole in a lower looper. Okay, this, and different overlocks has different this like little helper. You see this like little like a threading mechanism that will help you to thread it. So if you hold this, you can actually make it longer. You hold this and you turn this mechanism, turn actually your looper a little bit to lower position, and you turn it, and you see this helper is bringing the thread that need to be, you see, just go around of this like little like a hook, like a stick over there. And that's it. This is all the job this little helper does, just helping to thread it through this mechanism. And in case, look now what's happening now, you see that the needle, the threads from the needle went already down. We need to pull them up. We need to pull them up before we start stitching, you see? So we pull all these threads out, and from the looper, we also pull it through, and I take it all the way here. I pull them under the pressing foot, on the side, see? And in this way, we're all done. Now we can stitch. So you need to start. If anything happened with the threads, with the looper threads, anything happened, it got broken, you need to start from the disposition, you see, from the like default position. And everything, all the four threads you can see over here. So no chain formed yet. And then we can. Let's say we'll cut this type of the stitching. Okay, to adjust a little bit your stitching. So, and for this fabric now, as you can see, it's almost a good quality, a perfect quality. So that the knots of upper and lower looper need to go just along of the edge of the fabric. So it's almost good, but little bit you can adjust here. So the blue, what is upper looper, need to be a little bit more tighten. So I will tighten it just little bit, and we'll stitch it again. So like here a little bit tighter. Mm-hmm. That's it. You can see now everything is forming absolutely flat and beautiful, and it's the knot area goes just in the, at the edge of the fabric. Very important, if you make a knot, for example, if you change threads, you probably know you need just to make a knot and pull the threads through the all these steps. Very important that you double check that no threads coming in the top of the tension plates. Like for example, sometimes it can happen like that. You can see, that the thread is goes just over here, and then is everything done correctly, but something happened, it's come out from the tension plates, the quality will be absolutely wrong, no, not right. Then we can just need to pull it here and pull it from this side, and you see, make it go down in between. So if, in the case, if your blue, like upper threads goes too tight and will pull red, what is lower looper up, we need to make your blue, which is upper level, like more loose. And if it's going on the opposite way, we need to make loose the red, so it can be pulled by the upper looper in the top. I'll show you with a different fabric. It's a knit fabric, and thin, and sometimes that overlock has some, you know, difficulties, because this fabric is pretty easy to check. But if you work with this fabric, or for example, like this, you see, very thin rayon, it could be a different story. So let's try with this and we will see what is going on. Oh, you see, this is exactly what I want to show you. You see how now it goes? Not such as beautiful, right? As here. You see? So the red threads is pulling what is the lower looper is too tight, and it's pulling blue upper looper over the edge. So we need to make it loose, more loose, like the red lower looper need to be loose. So what I will do, I will make it here instead of 6, moving to, let's say, 4.5. And let's try it now. Okay, look now, perfect, this side and this side, okay, and also the needle threads also having very good tension, we cannot see threads through this, okay, so perfect. I want to show you one more of this fabric. Okay, perfect. So if you can see, again, we need to adjust even in this fabric. So whatever fabric you use, you need to make a little adjustment. I mean, you still can stitch with it, but I would say the blue is a little bit loose, you see? The red is perfect. So I would make red a little bit loose and blue a little bit tighter. Oh, and look now. Perfect. See? Nothing loose. And this absolutely flat, you see, from both sides. Also, if you see something like that happen with your stitching, you see like kind of like a loose, like a hoops on the side of the overlock, like on the edge, then you have two solutions. Of course, yes, you can pull a little bit thread tension, but also sometimes we need to move the knife. And if you're looking here, the knife now it's in this position, and different overlock has different regulators, but they all have the regulators to regulate the distance, you see, this distance. Like for example, if I move it, you see knife moving here. If I move it there, knife moving this way. So if I see that my knife is cutting too close, Then I will need to make this lip a bit wider. You see, cutting line. And then it will fill the distance, all this like width between stitching and finishing of the overlock knots over here. That's it, my dears. I hope this will be helpful for you to understand how to adjust your overlock machine, how to use it, and how to make different on different fabrics perfect stitching quality. Don't forget to put a like if you like this video, subscribe to my channel, and looking forward to see you in my next video. Bye bye.